हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। हियर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जनरल ट्री एंड बाइनरी ट्री, द कंपैरिजन ऑफ बोथ एज वेल एज हाउ टू कन्वर्ट जनरल ट्री टू बाइनरी ट्री I am going to cover in this current video. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos from my channel. Now let's start with the types of trees. Basically there are these two types. They are general tree and a binary tree. This is the example of general tree and this is the example of binary tree. Here name itself suggests that this is the general tree where there is no any specific condition. It is very general. But this is the binary tree. It is having a specific condition, and which is that condition, that I am going to explain you very soon. So now let's start with the general tree. With this example only I am going to explain you what is general tree. So now the first concept is tree is a non-linear data structure. That may be a general tree or a binary tree, but tree is a non-linear data structure. If you want to know about the details of the different types of data structures, which are those for you, I'm going to provide you a shortcut link in this right up corner, which is introduction to data structures. You can go through that and then you can resume this video. Now let's consider you are knowing the concept of non-linear data structure, as tree is a non-linear data structure. Now in general tree, the general tree where always each node can have either 0 or many number of child nodes. There is no any restriction. Minimum 0 and maximum number, there will not be any restriction. That's why this is, I have written over here, the arbitrary number of child nodes. Because the number of child nodes are, there is no any restriction. Here you can see that this is the root node having 4 number of child nodes. This is a node who is having a single child node. This is a node who is not having any of the child node, that is 0 child node. So in this way, the number of child nodes, there is no any restriction. So as there is no any restriction on the number of child nodes, so there are many number of subtrees are available in the general tree. Now the basic concepts about general tree is that in degree, that is nothing but how many incoming edges to the every node, are nothing but 1 always, because this is the concept of tree, except the root node, because root is the node who is not having any in degree. Any in degree there will not be available with the root node. And for rest of all the nodes, the number of in degree is 1. It means that the every node is having a single parent node, that you need to keep in mind. This is the concept with respect to general tree as well as any type of the tree, we can say that. But the main difference is about with respect to the out degree, that is for the out degree, the maximum number of child nodes are arbitrary, they are n. This is not the case with the help of binary tree. For the binary tree, it is different. So for the general tree, the out degree means outgoing edges from the every node are maximum up to n. They are arbitrary. There is no any restriction. There is no any limit. Now let's move forward for the binary tree. Binary tree is also a non-linear data structure, but it is a specialized version of the general tree. It is a general tree, but it is a specialized version. So what is the speciality of binary tree? So the special condition is that if the node is there for every parent node, minimum 0 number of child nodes or maximum 2 number of child nodes. So restriction on the maximum number of child node is there, which is 2. So maximum number of children are 2. So that's why the name is given binary. Binary, it means 2. So maximum 2 number of children can be there to every parent node, either 0, 1 or maximum 2. Up to 2 is the limit for every node. So this is the example of the binary tree, where you can see that the every node is having maximum 2 number of child nodes. Now I would like to give you a suggestion that if you don't know about the concept or the terminologies of the tree, they are root node, child node, parent node, edges, branches. For that you can go through my previous video, which is nothing but the introduction to tree data structure. I am providing you a shortcut link in this right up corner. After going through that terminologies, you will be able to understand all these concepts very easily. So now let's assume all of you are knowing the concept of these terminologies, and let's move forward the next point, where as the every element, every node is having maximum 2 number of children, so typically we call them as a left child and right child. Now let's consider this is a root node A, and there are 2 maximum number of child nodes. So B is going to become a left child, C is going to become a right child. For a parent node C, F is going to become a left child, G is going to become a right child. So in this way we can give the name to the child nodes. It's not possible in a general tree because there is no any restriction on the number of child nodes. So that's why typically we can't give them a name to all that child nodes. Now let's move forward for the conversion of general tree to binary tree. There are 2 steps only. So let's consider you are having a general tree. In that general tree you need to delete all the branches originating in every node except the leftmost branch. So what does it mean? We need to keep only the leftmost child as it is, which is connected to its parent node, and all rest of branches or the edges we need to delete. So after deletion, what we need to do? But we need to form a binary tree. That's why all the nodes must be connected. So to connect them, the step number 2 is we need to draw the edges or the branches from the leftmost node to the node which is in the right. It means that all the siblings will get connected with each other from the leftmost child. So what actually we are going to do, that I am going to explain you with the help of example. So now let's consider this is the general tree with us, and now my step number 1 is remove all the edges, all the branches except the leftmost. So applying algorithm over here, and this is my step number 1. Here you can see that only the leftmost edges are remaining. The left child of 1 is 2, so that's why this edge is we have taken as it is. Next, for the root node 2 or a parent node 2, the left child is 6, so keeping the edge as it is. For the child for the parent node 3, the left child is 8, keeping the age as it is, and for the node 5, its left child is 9, keeping the age as it is. Rest of all the edges are removed or deleted. What does step 2 says? Here is the step 2, that we need to reconnect them. We need to reconnect all the siblings with each other starting from the leftmost node. So this 2 is connected with 3, 3 is connected with 4, 4 is connected 5, because all these are siblings and are the child node or were the child node of the parent node 1. For the same, rest of all I am going to connect with each other with only the sibling. This 6 is connected with 7 because 6 and 7 are sibling. 7 is not connected with 8 because 7 and 8 are not the siblings. We need to connect only the siblings. 6 is connected with 7, 8 there is no any sibling, so keep 8 as it is. 9, 10, 11 are the siblings, so connect 9 with 10, 10 with 11. After doing this, how your binary tree will look like this. This is only the binary tree which we have generated from the general tree. Let's move forward. This was your general tree. This was generated from your step 2, was the binary tree. But now restructuring it, your tree will look like this. And now this is in the form of binary tree, where every node is having either 0, 1 or maximum 2 number of child, maximum child. So here you can see that 6, which is not having any left child, so only 7 will be its right child. For node 3, it is having only the left child, so 3 is having the left child previously, but after connecting 3 with 4, 3 is having a right child 4. For the 4, there is no any left child available. 4 is connected with 5, 5 is going to become the right child of 4, and so on. 5 is having its left child, 9 and 10. 9 is connected with 10 as a 10 right child of 9, and 11 as a right child of 10, and so on. So in this way, the conversion of the general tree to binary tree is going to be happen by applying a formula. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please like my video. Please give the comment or the suggestion in the comment, and please do share it with your friends. Here I am giving you a subscription link. Please do subscribe if you have not yet subscribed my channel. I am providing you the shortcut link for the next video of this series. Along with this, I am providing you the playlist for the same video session. Thank you friends. Keep watching. Thank you.